So, you know, like this is kind of like a weird reunion book. It's not my book. It's by a former dancer from Ingeborg Heuser. She went and she cataloged all of the years from the very beginning of the university, Texas Western University, all the way to the Civic Ballet, Ballet El Paso, whatever, all of these names of it, all of these of Ingeborg Heuser in her lifetime. And it's kind of interesting because it has, line for line, even each little dancer that danced. Yeah, so it's kind of interesting that way. Because it's a historical year by year, from whenever it began, you know, 50 years ago. So it's kind of a neat book. It's called Love of Dance, and it's something to add to your repertoire, because there was a lot of amazing dancers that Miss Heuser brought to Texas, that she brought from international arenas all over the world, and so it's kind of a, oddly I did not buy the book yet, but I did see it, it's all of those, it's not necessarily just a reunion book of those who danced in the area, you know, danced in all those productions. It's also historical, on Miss Heuser, historical synopsis of how she left Germany, how she brought herself here, and blah blah blah, to open up all the studios, to become a ballet mistress, a choreographer, a director. All of these things, you know, and it didn't happen overnight. She didn't just all of a sudden start making Nutcrackers and Cinderellas. I mean, in the beginning, it was just, you know, a lot of small little ballet schools, you know, until she worked up quite a few people. And then, you know, luckily a university took her. Yeah, the university took her and gave her the opportunity. And with that, she had all of the people from the university to help, you know. We had wonderful people at the university through the years, but it's amazing how many universities have dance departments, but they do nothing, really. They might make a spring recital, but some people like Miss Heuser, they just facilitate, they just take grab of the opportunity. And they choreograph and choreograph and choreograph, and they bring in dancers, and they find money somehow, and they pay those dancers. So yeah, she was excellent for a small regional company to give breath to the Southwest, you know, give breath, a dance breath. So it's a new book out there, and it's called Love of Dance, and it's written by Christina Palmer, and she says it took her 3 years to catalog it and get all of the information. So, but it's quite exciting, you know. If you're interested in the history of dance, that really does tell the last 50 years in the region of this, southern New Mexico, eastern Texas, you know. Just like, so great for her. Anyway, yeah, that's that. I just wanted to mention it. It was kind of neat. I like the forum of going to a historical dance presentation. It was very interesting. It was kind of like, made me want more, you know. I wanted to go see, you know, bring me one with Petrushkas and the Petipas, bring all of that, you know, and all of the Nijinsky, we want to see that. And, you know, I love that you know, you're just sitting there in the chair watching, but you're still surrounded by others who love dance. And that's the coolness, when you're surrounded with other people that really wanted to go there to watch dance. Then it kind of puts you in a place, doesn't it? Puts you in a place and you're like, wow, you know, this is my group in an odd, weird, strange way. You know, it's another, you know, dance aficionado group. And they're just, you know, we have to continue having these dance aficionado groups or, you know, where will we go? So off to that, I have to end this video, but I believe that was it for me. I just wanted more. I wanted more history of dance. I wanted more history of dance presentations. How amazing. And that can be done all around the United States, all around France, all around Europe. Yeah, dance presentations. Because when we go back to the very, very beginning, you're going back to Bournonville and you're going back to all of these training techniques, there's so much data, there are so many photos, and there's so much even live, there's video, you know, we can see old videos that is just hidden, still hidden away, and when you have regional areas, they're not like San Francisco, because in San Francisco we have like KQED, which is a wonderful channel, and it's dance, dance, dance. You either get, they have dance pretty much every day, they have a fresh ballet, but in regional areas you don't have that in America, so you just have this kind of a weirdo group of aficionados, and we're like, well, that would be something cool to watch also, because we don't always get to watch ballet. So that would be something that not only fosters dance and continues it and creates an art world, an art hold of art culture in dance, but it becomes a socializer also, and it keeps a bond with the people. You know, you keep a bond with them, therefore dance gets continued. You know, we get to continue dance. Get to continue dancing and have dancers. Anyway, that's that. Anyway, love of dance.